It's the last few dying minutes of E3 2011. We're here at the Sony Online Entertainment booth, and I caught up with Ulf, who's finally showing off his next game, Payday the Heist, with your new company, Overkill. What's it like to show it here at E3?
It's been great. I mean, we've been working on it sort of under the radar for the last 18 months or something like that. And, you know, we're a bunch of guys who loves making games, so we're just, you know, back on it again, making something that, you know, that we want to play. So
yeah, and that's something that you really sort of focus on. That this game is all about gameplay, all about the gameplay experience.
Yeah. Well, basically, we sat down and said, okay, what do we want to play, and how can we make a game that we actually can play during lunch hours and stuff like that? Yeah, he freaks me out too. And basically, we said, okay, cooperative gaming is what we like, and you know, high replayability is something we also, you know, need to have. Because if you make like a single player game as a developer, you know the story already, you know all the levels, and it's not as fun to actually, you know, devote yourself to. So we sort of went for this, and we're also movie buffs. I mean, Heat is one of my, I'd say the one movie I really, really love. And we sort of combined those, right?
So it is sort of a subject matter that some developers have tried to explore in the past. Maybe Kane and Lynch is something on a similar line, although that's a linear storyline. There was a game called The Heist that never came out from In Exile Entertainment. But still, what's sort of unique about your game, and where do you feel it sort of fits into the dissing array of games that are out here at E3?
Well, it's not a military game for one, you know, so there's a lot of military games here. But also, I mean, if you compare it to other heist games, one of the unique things about it, it's actually coming out. That's, you know, it's not just announced, so that's also cool. But also, it centers a lot around actual team play, where it's not going to be any backstabbing, grief play stuff. It's actually team play, you know, cooperative gaming. And it's tailored for cooperative gamers. So we want to hit that market and, you know, deliver something that they want to play. And, you know, and it's basically what we want to play too. So
what are people playing here at E3? Is it a particular mode or a particular map?
We only have one mode in game, basically. So yeah, it's one map. It's the bank job map, and it's all about making a heist from A to B of a bank. So you basically you enter the bank without any mask on, and sort of stake out the place, you know, and then you need to figure out where all the cameras are and the security guards and stuff like that. But you can also at any point just pull up your gun and start screaming at people and stuff like that, you know. So you have to take hostages, you know. Hostages in the game are used like extra life. Like somebody dies, you actually have to trade him for a hostage. So you have to guard the hostages, but then the cops want to sort of extract the hostages. So they'll try to smoke you out, and they'll try to, you know, use shield guys and stuff like that. And the scenario is highly dynamic, so you never know where the enemy's gonna come from. Like they might come from the ceiling, or like open up new pathways you won't have seen before. So every time you play, we play it slightly differently, and all the combat sequences are gonna be completely different. So you can never really learn, like, yeah, I'm okay. If you and me play, it's not gonna be like, oh, I go in and I do that and you do this. Like, if we have a plan, probably fail, you know. So we have to roll with the punches and sort of improvise all the time. So yeah.
So each map, is it more less of an arena and more of a sort of a progressive that you're moving forward towards a goal?
Yeah, it's a scenario game. So I mean, the bank job is basically like you go in, you take the hostages, find the bank manager, get his key card. You open a storage room where there's a drill hidden. You use the drill to open to get into the vault area. You also acquire some thermite, which is also hidden inside the bank, and which is basically this. You know what thermite is? It's inside of So you use that to sort of melt a hole into the vault, extract the cash, and then you have to escape with it to the escape vehicle, which is a dump truck in this particular one. So it's basically done. It's basically the whole thing, you know. Not just like there's a cutscene and then some shooting and then there's a cutscene, you know. It's actually trying to give you that complete experience. Yeah.
I have to ask this because there was a little bit of a publicity thing that your brother went out with a few weeks back. Oh. I have to say, is there a level where you go to a Japanese publisher to get your payday?
No, man. No. No.
Nothing like that.
No.
Only real life crime.
But there is fax machines in the game. Yeah, there is.
Oh, those can be useful sometimes. Yeah, if you want to send something out.
Yeah, especially, yeah.